Playing basic sounds and music in GameMaker Studio is actually quite easy. It's just up to you to decide when you want them to trigger inside your game. Now in my project, over here in my resource tree, I've got two sound effects and one MP3 for a song. And I'm not going to show you inside them because I've already gone over that in the sound video and you can check that out on your own time. Down here, I've got two objects. I've got a listener and a radio. This is just kind of like a player object. Now inside, in the create event, I'm just initializing some variables, and for that, it's just the speed, so I can move them around the screen 8 pixels per step. This is his movement code if you want to pause and take a look at it, but it's not important for audio. Down here, for global left pressed, so that's every time I click down my left mouse button, anywhere, globally, so that's anywhere in the room, I'm going to play a bullet sound. And here's the function. It's really this easy. Audio. That's the beginning of the function. And then inside audio, we want it to play sound. There are three arguments for playing any sound. This also includes music. But there are three arguments. One is the ID for the sound. So that's the ID from your resource tree. So I'm picking sound bullet. It's this one. The next one is the priority. Now this has to do with the number of channels that are available. Depending on the device that you're going to output your game for, you may have a limit on how many audio channels you have. And if you exceed that limit, some sounds need to be dropped. They will just cut away completely. And the ones that will cut away completely are the ones with the lowest priority. So I've set my bullet to be 1, which means it's a very low priority. So if I exceed the number of channels I have, let's just say I have 64 channels. So I can have, let's say, 64 sounds. But if I have a 65th sound that's played, the bullet sound will drop from the channel so it can play whatever that new sound is. The last argument is whether or not the sound will loop. Now, since this is just one sound effect, I don't want it to loop. It's not music, so I set that to false. Remember, true and false can also be 1 and 0. And then, of course, you would have all your code for creating the bullet and having it shoot across the screen and whatever else you need to do, but I'm just going to focus on playing the sound. So that's all that object does. Now I've also got a radio. In here, in my create event, so when this object is created, or perhaps when the instance of the object is created, I'm going to do the exact same function, which is audio play sound, because this is also used for music. Keep in mind that at the time of recording this video, there is audio play music, but that has been deprecated. So as before, there are three arguments. I'm going to select the sound ID, which for this I'm choosing background music intro. I've set the priority to 10, so it is a little more high up. It's a bit higher on the priority list because I don't want my music to drop out. I could even make it 100. It really doesn't matter. It's kind of an arbitrary number. It's just for you to create your own hierarchy of which sounds are more important than others. Almost like depth in a way. And this one I do want to loop. I've set it to true because I want this song to loop whenever it hits the end of the song. Now, before I show you any other functions, let's just hop into the room and kind of just see what that looks like. Okay, so as you can see, I've got my radio here. My player is following my mouse and he moves around. We'll get into that later. So this radio right here, this instance, is creating the song. Once it was created, it started playing this sound ID. Now, whenever I left click, I create a bullet sound. And that's it. Those are the two things. That's how audio play sound works. Now let's look at some other functions involved in basic audio. Going back into the object radio, in the step event, I've got controls for the music. Now this is a little confusing at first, so let's just kind of go through it step by step. I've got an if statement. Whenever I press the P key on my keyboard, that's what I'm checking for. What I'm going to do is pause the music if it's playing. So here are these functions I want to show you. I've got if audio is paused. So this is a function that checks to see if whichever music, whichever index you're looking for, is paused. So I'm saying if it's not paused, and that's this sound ID, the music, then audio pause sound. So if it's not paused, I'm going to call this function to pause it quite easily. That's simple. And then if it's already paused, I want the audio to resume sound. So these are two functions that work together. We have audio pause sound and audio resume sound. Now there's an important distinction to make here. Down here I've got the exact same setup using the backspace key, but I'm using two functions called stop and play. Now we've already used audio play sound, but this is audio stop sound. Now of course, both of these if statements will make the music not heard. It will drop to zero volume, you won't hear it. This one, though, will pause the sound at exactly where it is in the music. So if I press P to audio resume sound, it will pick up at the exact moment where I paused it. But if I stop it and then play it again, it'll start at the beginning of the song again. So those are two important distinctions to make. Stop makes it so your audio goes back to the beginning of the sound file, and pause keeps it wherever it was when you pause the sound. I mean, it works exactly like you would on a sound file, a CD, a tape, whatever. When you pause, it resumes at the same spot. Now, it's probably worth noting that I'm using the actual sound ID from my resource tree. Now, if I had multiple instances of this particular sound, let's say I was using SoundBullet instead, I put SoundBullet into each one of these functions, and I had multiple enemies all utilizing that sound effect, so they're all using SoundBullet, I've got like six of them going on, pew 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 pew. If I say pause sound or stop sound, it'll stop every single one of the instances of this sound, which you might not want to do. You might only want to stop one particular instance of a sound. So in that case, let's go back to create. When I start this, instead of saying audio play sound, I can actually store this in something like, I don't know, let's just say BGM as the variable. So now this particular sound I'm playing, the index for it will be stored inside this variable. So if I wanted to, and I'll show you the difference actually inside the room, but if I wanted to, I could replace this now with just the variable and pause just the one instance of that sound. But before I do that, let's just go back and I'll show you what the P key does to pause the music and what the backspace key will do to stop the music. Okay, so here we go. Now, I'm drawing the state up here just so you can see. The music is playing, sure. Now, if I pause it, the music is paused, we don't hear it anymore, but it's going to stop right at that part where I paused it, and if I press P again, using audio resume, there we go, it's exactly where I paused the music. But if I press backspace and stop the music, there, music is stopped. Now it's not actually running anymore, it's not stored. So if I press backspace again to start the audio again, I'm back at the beginning of the song. There are a couple more functions I want to show you that are actually closely related to these. Rather than pausing or stopping a specific sound, or specific music for that matter, we can actually use the word all. So I can say sound stop, let's just erase that for a sec. So now we've got these drop down. As I said, music is deprecated, we don't want to use that one. But I can say audio stop instead of a particular sound index, I can say stop all. Now this doesn't need an argument, because this will stop all sounds that are happening right now, each and every one of them. And you can actually do that for pause as well. I could say pause all, and this wouldn't require an argument because I'm not selecting any particular index or resource ID. This will pause all of the sound in the game. This actually might be important for you if you actually pause your game, like if there's a pause menu and you don't want there to be any sound or any music. Right when you pause your game, you can say audio pause all, and it'll just pause all of the sound that's playing. And then you can actually do the same for resume. You can say audio resume all. And then of course, no index for that because we're going to resume all of the sounds. So there we go, those are actually the basic ways of implementing audio into your game. Audio play sound is how you just play the sound, and you decide which event you want to use it in, whether when this instance is created, when I press the mouse button, when the instance dies, when the instance collides with a wall, jumps off a Goomba, I don't care. It doesn't matter. It's whatever fits into your game, and then you can call this particular sound. And then, of course, there are different functions for pausing, resuming, and stopping all sounds or particular sounds, which you can call the particular ID from in your resource tree, which will stop every instance of that sound, or you can store it inside a variable and then pause or stop just that one variable while the other ones continue to play.